Tagata, how many times have you done this?
Not very much.
Ana Moceyawa never shies away from a new challenge.
Got to get it right, otherwise the kids will complain.
And you can always count on her to finish the job. The 28-year-old has been a judo fighter since she was 10, but at next month's Commonwealth Games, she'll be lining up against some of the world's best in wrestling.
It was awesome. I have been waiting for quite a while, and getting that email of confirmation was awesome. Just that feeling of, okay, I'm definitely going.
Judo's been excluded from this year's games, but that wasn't stopping Ana from chasing her Commonwealth dream. So in 2015, she stepped up to the plate and decided she'd give wrestling a go. But despite similarities to judo, she had to grapple with a few challenges.
From judo to wrestling would definitely be no submissions in wrestling, so no armbars or strangles. It's very open for that. Naturally, I just want to go in and break their arm. Apart from the submission, it would be the clothes. I had to come into wrestling and they gave us these wrestling singlets and they're like, oh, this is what you wear out there. And I was like, what? Like, you feel so exposed.
But Ana embraced the demands of the sport, and even a leg injury couldn't stop her rapid rise to the top.
2017 was definitely my year. Like, I got everything, I had no injuries, made my weights really good, won Oceania's again in Tahiti.
She saved the best for last, bringing home bronze at the Commonwealth Champs in December and a qualification for the Commonwealth Games.
I trained every day and put my all into it, so it was definitely like hard work paid off when I got selected, and it was like showing me that if you do, you can put your mind to something, you can and achieve it. One hand on the head and shoot. There we go, nice.
Now with the big gold ticked off the list, you'll find Ana here at Otu Muay Thai College in Tauranga, giving back.
So if you're going to shoot, you can take a breath and then shoot. I would have been like laughing if someone told me that in a couple of years' time I'll be in this position here, but it definitely is very rewarding to be able to see these guys grow and watch them win medals and everything like that.
But with few Pacific people in the sport, Ana hopes to one day extend her reach to her father's homeland of Fiji.
They're so athletic, like when I go back to the islands and see my family, I see little five-year-olds that are like climbing trees and sprinting around, and I'm like, oh my gosh, if we got them into sport here, like, they'd be animals.
For now though, she'll be pledging her allegiance to New Zealand. And while she may have achieved her qualification, it's fair to say she isn't done just yet.
I will be looking to get in the final, but I've definitely set that bottom line goal is to get on that podium.